Okay, guys, we are back ready for the beginning of round five, final round today. And at the top table is Lou Witham from Harlequins, following his win against Simeon. Running Omega Leader with Duke and Com Relay, Vader in his TIE Advanced with Predator, Proton Rocket, TIE X1, Engine Upgrade, an Advanced Targeting Computer, and rounding out his list to 100 points is the Inquisitor with Push the Limit, Proton Rockets, TIE V1 and Auto Thrusters. And playing against him is our very own Kev Bellamy, running three Contracted Scouts. The first with Proton Torpedoes, Extra Munitions, Boba Fett, R4 Agrimech, a Tiny Mind Link and Guidance Chips. The second one running Plasma Torpedoes, Extra Munitions, 4 LOM, R4 Agrimech and a Tiny Mind Link with Guidance Chips. And the final one is Plasma Torpedoes, R4 Agrimech, a Tiny Mind Link and Guidance Chips.
Now, are we, is this effectively what's going to amount to a final here?
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Pretty much for the whole weekend.
Whoever wins this is going to win, aren't they?
Yeah, it depends on MOV. I think we've got one or two other people the same score.
Someone else on another table could clinch it. That's what.
That's what happened yesterday.
What happened yesterday? Yeah.
Cool. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so we've not got anybody on a full set of wins then?
Not yet.
I think so.
Lewis might have. If you check with her, she's got the score sheet.
There we are, setting up with the asteroids.
Well, despite what you may see on the screen, this is indeed Kev Bellamy. He's just
affectionately known as the third Delapina.
Yeah, the Delabellapinas. He has. We're assuming he's lost his eggs because he's turned up with triple scouts.
Yeah. It's worked out well for him so far. I mean, like I say, he's at top table.
But it's Kev.
It is Kev.
that's the problem.
So the top table are the only two that are 4-0.
Oh, right. Ooh, okay, so this is definitely,
so
definitely
if
it. Whoever
winner
wins
will
this
win.
Will win the day.
So a bit of a mix-up today.
Oh. So Kev needs to win this for Warlords.
It'll be the first time a non-team member has won in a very long time, I believe.
It's true, and it'll be interesting to see if Kev manages to go all the way without his eggs.
Can I quit looking at the room ball?
Come on, Kev.
We're just setting up. Nearly ready to go.
Ah, you don't need you.
Wait for this.
Fine, we'll tell terrible things about you.
Wait for Ash to give the go ahead for the round to begin. This pans out because this is to take everything today.
Yeah, it's a lot closer than yesterday. Yesterday was, there were about four or five people who could have made the final depending on MOV.
There was, it was very close yesterday. Today there will be one clear winner. And we'll see how we get on.
No.
Looks like there's something dials ready to go. Lou pretty much setting up exactly as he did last time, just in the opposite corner.
Really hoping on a Kev.
The handshake, it looks like Kev has set up his Jumpmasters all touching.
Yeah.
One final check of the dials for the go ahead.
Just gonna have a quick reminder to them about stream stuff, you know, damage cards, dice rolls.
In a minute now. I'm not going to Okay, well, it looks like we are good to go. Kev going first with his scouts, all on the lower initiative. And he's going straight in with the hard two. And I think we're going to barrel roll from the off. Very close to the edge of the board there.
Right, just had a quick chat. They're in a great mood.
Good to see.
Apparently, there is an inner rivalry going on as well.
Okay.
They've played each other a couple of times. They're now 1-1.
It's a grudge match. Yeah. That's the second jump master with the hard two and the barrel roll.
Conger is.
And I think we're having the same again with the third. Kev there with his. Ooh, top 16 rolling. Regional template, so maybe not.
Focus. Get that Atani started up.
And here comes the Inquisitor. The symbol 2 forward. And we are going for the 1 boost there. Up and to the left. Two forward with the Mega Leader, two.
Barrel, focus.
These guys are 1-1. Fair to say that this could be a fairly evenly matched game, but Lou does have a lot of hull and shields to power through. In the grand scheme of things, all of those ships are that Kev's running are pretty chubby. With the exception of maybe that last scout.
A lot of firepower's come out ready as well. However, the last times they fought, Kev was with his Ziggs, which he's used for years now.
He is nigh impossible to beat with his Ziggs.
Unless you're me, I have this weird thing for him. him and George, every now and then I'll just sneak a win in. And they're very confused every time.
I think that's the thing, isn't it? I mean, it doesn't matter how good you are at the game, how confident you are on your list, there will always be a time where they can be beaten. And credit to, again, the X-Wing community. Everybody generally takes it on the chin. Everybody has bad days as well. I know Em, speaking to her in between, hasn't had a great day with her list so far, which is generally a list she's reasonably confident with. And usually places quite well, but so far she's 0-4.
Well, you know the answer, right? You've got to go to a tattoo parlour and write auto thrusters on her hands. I know a few people are having this problem where they need to just remember
bits. I always forget auto thrusters. All my issues with Fen, I'll confuse myself between the title and auto thrusters.
Yeah.
It's easily done.
Yeah.
With a 1 bank from the first scout.
So it'll be another 1 bank.
The only one who stayed around doing sweet FA!
This is the
lovely first one.
Yeah, this is a nice aggro map build version.
Two back there. Thing. You're thinking.
Yeah, clips bringing them up. There.
I think we're in the bump already. Unfortunate.
Slightly out of practice though. Yeah. He's just going for that focus for the first round. Get the target lock ready for his proper strike the next round.
Yeah, one bank with the remaining scout. Inquisitor.
That's a lonely Inquisitor out there on his own.
Barrel roll, keep himself out to range 3.
That'll
be beyond at this point in the game.
That'll be a hard left next turn, ready.
Hard 2 with the Mega Leader.
Very cautious start.
Yeah.
Oh, I feel like a snooker commentator.
Three, yeah. Well, 3 jumps is intimidating to go up against. You know, it's 3 ships with turrets, 3 lots of shields and hull to get through, which is very whack. And the only other list where I can think of having that much hull with the same ship throughout. And mostly basic pilots, probably the swarm of bees.
You've also got the a bit the less manoeuvrable triple Trando build.
Oh yeah.
I remember. What was it? There was the buses.
Part of the bus.
3 at once. Yeah. I know Shane used to love running his triple Trando. No one else loved it.
Well, yeah, I mean, it's pretty slow running, it's the one ship that I just hate the arc of.
Yeah, until wave 11.
Until wave 11.
Yeah, that nice Azotic Wookiee gunship.
An amazing reinforce action.
Yeah.
But I really don't know, depends how many we're really going to see. Again, it's another rebel ship with low agility and not so great on the attack, but plenty of holding shields.
That's fine. It's not like they'll get many of them, like, say, I don't know, a Havoc as well. Yeah, oh,
there
great.
Is,
yeah.
Well, yeah.
All things that will do really well with the TLT meta. Yeah. I don't know. I wonder if they're building up for a rotation system so older stuff is less able
left
to be
in the
used.
Dark,
yeah, where they start rotating things out so the new stuff that isn't that fancy coming in is more usable.
Well,
lower
yeah.
the average.
I mean, I'm hoping that Disney and FG see that there's a ton of stuff in the old expanded universe still worth using. You know, and X-Wing, while a great tabletop game in itself, you know, Star Wars is Star Wars. It's played by Star Wars fans. People know and want stuff like
snowspeeders.
Yeah, potentially. You know, it's that sort of thing.
Tie Striker is a space worthy, but it's also mainly atmospheric. So, snowspeeder is an option. My personal favourite still hasn't made it in, the Naboo N1 Starfighter.
I'd like to see some prequel stuff come in, more than the Arc 170.
Yeah, because it's even canon still, what with Episode 1 and the Leia comic. Yeah, is that hard left one?
I'd be interested to see some of the droid ships coming in.
Yeah, I think the biggest issue with any of those...
They're just standard loadout type stuff, though, that's the issue.
Yeah. Well, it'd be more faction. The Separatist doesn't really fall into any of them. And same with the...
Yeah, but the Republic doesn't either, does it?
if anything, that would probably go towards Empire.
Yeah.
And that's the worst part. I don't know. So, probably push for a target lock to get his free evade. Yep, there we go.
It's not like they haven't brought some of the Expanded Universe ships in. They were brought in a few before they got bought by Disney.
Yeah.
The E-Wing.
But Disney wasn't a... Disney's more interested in the canon stuff.
Yeah. But it's not like there aren't people willing to pay money for these extra ships. I mean, there can't be that many scum and villainy canon ships at the moment.
There's nowhere near as many as there are out.
I mean, I don't think, I'm not necessarily that old.
Jabba's sail barge, you know?
Yeah, but I don't know, I can't think of anywhere the Sea Rocks appeared.
It was in Rebels.
Was it?
I'll be honest, I was expecting the Lady Luck rather than the Sea Rock. Which I think was in the... almost missed it. Going away to old nostalgia. So that'll be...
A hit and a crit there.
Yeah.
Against Kev.
He's got focus.
Focus and evade all of it.
No Omega Leader lock yet. No arc from Inquisitor. So all that's left is Vader, which hasn't got range. Vader first. The Mega Leader just shot and missed. So that's Kev's turrets.
Pretty much all of them back. We'll see how he's going to do. What old Expanded Universe ships would you like to see to come to the game, man?
Don't think we'll see any.
I don't think we will.
Because since Disney's took over, we haven't had anything that's non-canon.
The Havoc is coming.
Yes.
Which is out in a video game. Canon.
Yeah, which is out in a video game. But what we see it is, it's also out in Armada. Will we see it? Will we see it make an appearance in a Marvel comic? Will we see it?
That's
in
very
Rebels?
True. I mean, it might be pre-planning for stuff. Yeah.
Sacramento.
Still no N1 Starfighter, which has been in the comics.
I know, I kicked off about this more than once. I want Princess Leia as a pilot.
Yeah,
I'd expect
not a crew that sees incredibly little use.
Yeah, I want Princess Leia in a Naboo Starfighter. That's what I want. It's canon. It's in the comic.
Yeah, because she parried our partner.
Well, it'll be interesting to see. Be interesting to see if there's anything new coming out of. Episode 8, but that'll be released.
Exactly. Obviously, we've got Celebration next week, haven't we?
We have.
America.
Is that next week?
Next week. So, and we're going to see so much good canon info. We're going
to
see the next.
Good week to start a podcast.
Be very interesting. We're going to have a ton of FFG announcements. We're going to have a load of canon announcements. You know, we're going to get the book announcements. Everything's going to be on fire.
It's going to be that trailer.
Trailer's coming. Yeah. The panels, they're going to have the guys out from the next movies. They may even announce the movie that's coming after, because obviously they're doing the Han Solo movie.
I'm expecting a teaser for Han Solo.
You could even get a teaser for Han Solo. They've got the cast together, haven't they?
It's going to be something, isn't it?
And look at all the people doing the panels. It's the 40th anniversary as well, so this celebration is insane.
Oh, I wish I was there.
I was so close to buying tickets on my way back from last year's celebration.
I didn't manage to get tickets for the London one.
Should I do it? Or America? It's a long way. Now I'm just thinking, damn it.
Kev. You know better than that.
There's a few bits I'd like to see.
Should be good for the rest.
Unfortunately, getting rid of the old EU.
Well, somewhat unfortunately, somewhat thankfully.
Yeah, some of it's
but
I reserve judgment until I've read Thrawn. So I'm a huge heir to the Empire, and you know, I loved Zahn's books, the Thorn Trilogy. Huge characters for me. Really gutted when they went. I mean, as most people were, that was our introduction into the EU.
Yeah.
Then I was, when they showcased Thrawn at Celebration being in Rebels, you know, they went ballistic. Yeah, and then they had a little talk with Timothy Zahn. He did a little, well, not a talk, but he did a little snippet and saying that he's co-wrote the new Thrawn, and then the book's out, I believe it's like
pretty soon. It's out in like this month.
So that's it. I shall read that. And Thrawn's been fantastic.
Yeah. I know people sort of...
He's not quite wired pictures, I'll be honest. He fits.
I think he fits perfectly.
He's just not quite...
How I'd imagine him out of the book. Yeah. I mean, people say Aftermath isn't that great, but I've really enjoyed it.
I've really enjoyed it. I haven't read book three yet.
I've not read any yet. I need to get the paperbacks.
It's really good.
If you can order the paperbacks, they're not mine.
I've got them here. I'll bring them on, you can borrow them.
I'll buy them.
Yeah.
I'll buy them.
Have
off
some
you.
Money, Ash.
Yeah, I
come on.
I don't think I can get the paperbacks. I can get the hardbacks when they're out, the new releases, but I don't think they stock the paperbacks.
I don't want hardbacks. Take too much space. Most of my Star Wars books are paperback.
I've got a good mix.
Oh, there's a proton rocket from Vader into the closest jump. That's not a bad one. Tauriel Lark into focus.
Unlucky.
That's four, it's not bad.
Is he spending focus or is he...
I don't know, he's taking everything away. We'll see what the shields say.
Still on the ship.
Okay, so he's taken... So yeah, he spent his focus. Yep. Taking three shields off. And no torp shot for that one, but the other one should be good.
It's from the Inquisitor, I think.
Yeah, that's the other rocket. Ouch. That's the same one. Oh, he's almost killed a torp off a scout already.
Let's see what the crit says.
What did he show us? He's suing us. Console fire. Okay.
That's not too bad.
One health left. And Omega Leader can't shoot him.
Nearly.
So we know what he's doing next turn. So, standard laser shot. And spend his focus, gain a target.
Pretty much. So Kev's returning. He's fall on it. Yeah, on the evade, I think.
And here's the torps.
Yeah. See if he gets on.
No mods needed on that one. One of eight. So, depends what the crit is. Blinded pilot. Just lives. And then the other one.
These jumps are so hard.
One hit. You say that, but one's almost just died immediately.
He's taking it out with rockets. It almost makes me want to run all A-wings against him with rockets.
Okay, so here's another torp going on to Omega Leader. Around the debris from the looks of it. So, spend his focus.
Three.
So your focus one. Is it plasmas or rockets? Garnish chips one.
Yeah.
Oh.
So
three hits.
Yeah. That's gonna stink.
That's him dead. Yeah, you can't dodge that.
Yeah.
Well, he killed one ship. Quite badly. Just put the whole damage deck on. That'll do it.
Man, so that's two of Kev's jumps. Last one. Is he going to be going for the Inquisitor maybe? Or is he going to go
No,
for
that
Vader?
Was his first two dice attack. Oh, no.
No, he's still got one. He's going for Vader.
Two hits. To get target lock, spend the target lock. Three hits. Very nice. And Vader takes a hit.
He's got a Vader token. Yeah, it's just the one.
Woo! No, not in the least bits.
back round to the dials.
So the noble Kev Bellamy, our local weekend warlord hero, taking on the invading foreigner from Harlequins. Oh, he's looking serious now.
Yeah.
He wants vengeance.
Off.
Kev's mostly dead ship does have a plasma top available, so if he gets ignored for a turn, he can bring it round, get that top off.
Which one on the of the ones that are on the in front of us is the one that's not down to one health?
The one in the middle. The bottom could, left of them.
Could power away.
Yeah, he can sloop, white sloop, and get his target lock ready for it. One of the other ones can give him
Vader's
a focus.
Vader's going to be moving out to those range 2 to 3.
Yeah. So if Vader does hard 3 left, hard 2 left, he should have a decent shot at the mostly dead one. But they'll leave the others to get a shot at his back.
I think that top one might be able to make the hard 1 left dodge. Yeah.
Dodge the debris.
It's going to be tight, yeah. He might be able to do it.
I don't think so, but I'm very pessimistic, so who knows? And would that really be any use when he's trying to get his torps off? Oh, well, I suppose he won't get a... He won't...
It's not
the
that
stress.
One, though, is it? It's the... I think he's only... Well, he's got torps and everything still, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's used... So the back two have used a torp each. But they're the ones who have extra munitions.
Extra munitions, yeah.
The one that doesn't have extra munitions is the one that's almost dead. So, and that one didn't shoot.
Yeah, it's going to be worth trying to pop that last lot of torps off. It's still a lot of dice.
That's the advantage of these. Just you don't care if your torps hit or not because you've got spares. Looking very tense and stressful out there.
A lot of thought going into this Vader dial.
Now here's the problem, I've played Kev plenty of times with his Iggs. I have no idea how he flies anything else,
yeah.
So I can't even guess. I mean, the worst I can think of is a one bank on the rightmost one, a sloop with the almost dead one, and the top one, maybe a hard one left, just trying to skim the debris.
The difficult thing is, all of his jumps will be moving first.
Yes. Oh, they're going for it.
Here you go. We're going
see how well I know Kev. Probably not at all.
This could be...
Oh, this looks like it'll be a sloop. Okay, so I've got one.
There's a sloop straight away.
And that's a white, so he can get his target lock. If he's... No? No target? Okay. That's a straight spare... well, bank. And he's just taking it. Maybe block the Inquisitor so you can get
probably
a good
better
torp
shot. It'll be worth it, given that it'll only take damage on the crit. It means he's got to stress the list, but really,
care.
Does he need to move far next turn? Not really.
Nope. Didn't take any damage on the thing. We missed that, but we saw it in the tiny camera.
Yeah, there you go. There's the
bump. Was not a block. That's gone through.
That's it.
Yeah.
Those pegs might touch, I don't know.
Oh, that's true.
Right, I think we're...
Wow.
Sorry. Yeah.
that's not a huge improvement, to be honest.
Wipe of the brow.
Because now the third one could shoot him as well, rather than just two.
Yeah, because he hasn't bumped either.
No. Yeah, it's good. Yeah, he gets his focus. But he's... is that Vader? I think that's Vader straight.
He's in trouble.
Yeah, Vader looks like he's done a fast
move. I think
move.
That bottom one has already got a target lock. But I think the locks might be the wrong way around.
Well, no, Kev's using different locks. Those are those two on the Inquisitor and the Jumpmaster are the Yavin ones. Kev uses his own made ones. That's Vader onto.
There's normal ones. Yeah. So,
we go for that. So Vader. So Inquisitor range one on.
Crit. Oh, hang on.
In the dice tray, please. A reroll.
Crit and a hit. Spending the target lock for another crit.
Very nice. I believe this is on the middle. In the tray. I believe this is the middle jump. Nope. He's just finished off the last one. So, one jump is down. But that leaves two to take shots at the Inquisitor at range one. Which is going to be.
Target lock for.
Best of luck to you, Lewis.
For Lou. Let's see how we go on here. I think he's kind of really only got a shot on.
Onto the. So range two on the other ship.
Yeah, I think,
and the top
jump. I think he's bumped on the bottom.
Oh no, this is Kev shooting, okay. So, Agromech shenanigans.
Yeah, spend the target lock for the reroll.
No, I think he's prepping a talk for next turn.
I see, yeah. So, two evades.
Two evades, all good. And then the other one is probably going to do the same thing.
How are we getting on here? It's unfortunate.
Getting a target lock. And you'll probably keep that for a talk as well. Yeah.
He's debating the spend for the reroll. And he's gone for
it. Spending for the reroll. Okay.
Three hits. There we go.
Three hits. Four. Oh! Three blanks. That's a nearly dead Inquisitor. That paid off very much so. Kev seems a bit in disbelief.
Okay, top of the next turn.
So now if Kev can. So what I'd do if I was Kev is, oh no, that won't work. Okay, so do a green maneuver with the top jump to the side, get the focus so the other one has target lock focus, and then bump straight forward so no movement, at which point target lock focus, and the Inquisitor is going to struggle to get out of that.
Yeah, I mean, I'd just block
massive
everything.
Massive torp shot.
Block everything.
And Vader's going to probably 4K, but if he does, no action, so not too much of a threat. Other than that, advanced targeting would be to. Oh no, it's not. That's an ion token, yeah. So not even a target lock yet on Vader.
Going down for that Inquisitor.
Kev's now ready. Yeah, he is hoping he's figured out what he's doing.
One for Vader. And still deliberating on the Inquisitor. There we go.
He's gone for it. Alright.
See how we turn out.
So he's not gone for my terrible strategy.
Getting a two bank out of the Jumpmaster hit.
Is that a sloop?
It is a sloop.
Throwing
everything
everywhere. But he has a target lock.
Does have a target lock.
As long as a green gets the focus.
It's really pushing in for that Inquisitor. Hard one from the other Contractor Scout.
And that is a green.
Debris. Clear that stress. Imagine he'll focus the list at this point. Yep, there we go.
So now, if the Inquisitor stays in Narc, which way is he going? Oh dear. Okay, so he should be able to clear out. He'll just boost and they'll be fine.
Still going to be a range 1 primary.
Oh yeah, that's always a lovely thing to have.
Especially maybe three. Even a range 1 primary from the other.
Nah, he's going to boost out of range.
Is he? No, he's target locked.
What?
He's target locked. He's pushing for a focus.
Oh, okay, he's playing it. What? This seems very unexpected. He's not boosted out of arc of the torpedoes. Oh, hang on. Plasmas are range 2 to 3.
They
he's
are,
fine.
Yeah.
That would be one. We get there in the end. So the Inquisitor's obviously going to be taking the brunt of this.
I think so. I mean, is that Inquisitor in range 1 of the second scout?
No.
Might just be out.
No, I'd say no. Okay, so we have got the Vader first, range 1. Oh, so
why is Vader not got the target lock? Why is he not going for the
I don't know.
Going for the advanced targeting
kit? Three shields.
Spend the focus.
No. Three shields. We've got shields to spare. Take them. Inquisitor now. Oh, Jesus. He's just not.
On the target lock, I think, is that.
Yeah. Oh! It's another hit, but that's fine. That's just a hit.
Another
that's the last
shield.
And now he's got a point blank shot from one and possibly both. I would take the locked one on Inquisitor first, because then the other one's got a range one on Vader. Okay. What's he looking for? What? Okay.
That Inquisitor. Really?
That's. Okay, it's a strange.
Two hits there.
It's two hits on Vader, which is not.
No, well, that's two hits on Inquisitor, I think, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, there we go. That's, yeah, okay, so he's gone range one on Vader from the look of things. Two hits and a crit. Just the evade. So can you spend the evade?
Now
I'll
take shield.
Shield, yeah.
Do it. Okay. Oh dear, and there's the target lock. So now range one on. What? Okay. Now I could be done, but I'm confused that this wasn't the first thing.
Shot with the right one first.
So the right one was on Vader.
Yeah.
But I'd have assumed he'd have done.
He's taken the
left
ion
one.
For four lump.
Yep, stop that evade token. The three hits.
Yeah.
And it's through.
Oh, two through.
So now Vader on just hull has two jump masters to take out.
And the Inquisitor's down.
It's looking good for Kev.
But
Kev.
It's Darth Vader.
Well,
it's Darth
it is Vader.
Vader,
you know.
Vader was out of the target lock as well.
He did bring the Republic to its knees.
On his own.
On his pretty much off his own back, yeah.
I've won games with just Vader. The you know.
Facing two jumps?
Facing the whole list with just Vader.
Wow.
Because everything else died too fast. Carnal Jax does not survive.
Well, let's turn that bottom jump. It's only going to go one forward.
Yeah. So that's the easy one at least.
The other one
stay stressed as well, which isn't great. The other one's probably going to sloop around, get just start pulling in on Vader, get those range shots in.
Well, if he's got torps left.
Because that one's not even been touched yet.
Ooh, really?
Yeah, still full shields. Or if not full shields, like most shields.
So, first guy down the bottom here is going to bump into Vader. The next guy, if he sloops, he's got probably going to have range with his torps, depending on what Vader does.
So focus up, give, because he's got target lock already,
focus
give the other
on
one
the
focus.
List. Have the iron tokens come off.
Yeah, Vader's gonna leg it.
Oh, Vader's gonna be out of that primary arc.
He should be able to get out of range one at least. I'd say take the evade. However, with Forlom on board. Okay, so there's a barrel to the side. That is definitely out of range one now.
Not going to be through the debris though.
Yeah, whichever one he goes for, he is going to be blocked by the Forlom. But it could be worth it just to give him that ion. Make later turns a bit easier.
That far right jump is going to be out of range.
Yeah. He's got a nice... This is mostly a family-friendly stream. But yeah, he's going to have two closing in on him for next turn.
Here we go.
So pull on that token away. That was a bit of speed up. Two hits and spend the focus, gain the target lock. Two evades. Vader is all good. Don't need no evades. And that will be it. So hard left on one.
Both jumps with the target lock on Vader.
Yep, and there are torps for both of them.
Could he be going for a hard right one with the jump to the right?
No. He'll do a bank because that will stay wide. Plus, it'll give him more arc options. There's the hard left.
Gonna be green, it's gonna clear his stress.
Yeah, I need to focus up the whole list. At which point, yeah, he could have done a res.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. And he's got pretty much the whole thing covered there.
Yeah, he's gone for the bank.
Two bank.
You'll probably focus as well.
And have another focus.
Always
is helpful. It worth another focus at this point? It's not, I can't really use it. Unless he...
He's not... Well, they don't like turning right, so he doesn't want a barrel roll left. He's going to take the debris next turn. Okay, makes sense.
Yeah, he can afford to.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's worked out nicely. Oh, yeah. Boy. Vader's...
Vader will get the extra one through the debris. Oh, here we go. Is he going to move in? Avoid those torps.
It's range one of one, range two of the other.
There we go. He's just going to move out of arc. Where is he?
Arc doesn't matter. They'll just be using turrets.
Well, if he wanted to use his torpedoes, is what I'm thinking.
Yeah. Ooh, nicely timed. Predator on the jump master. Okay. Kev is just burning it all. So, first jump.
Range two. So just the two attack dice from the jump masters there.
So turret first. From the left jump. One hit.
Spend the target lock for the reroll.
Yeah, then he'll spend his focus to regain his target lock.
Second guy.
Turret again.
Spend the target lock. Get the reroll. Hitting a crit.
And Fenn's focus regains target lock with the Aragamek. So hit crit, and it's a crit. Oh boy, what crit did he get? Damage. And it looks like that shake. Hey, Mr. Kev Bellamy, I think we're going to have a quick chat.
Yep, okay.
Very well done. Okay. Yeah.
Our final, we're going around to have a quick chat with them now.
All right, hello people. I've come to have a chat. I'll talk to the winner first. So, in our final, both Both players 4-0, the only ones in the store. So this game mattered. They also had a personal grudge match at 1-1.
Oh, you can't have a grudge against Lewis.
Okay.
No, there's no grudge. No grudge. We were 1-1 going into this.
A friendly history match.
A friendly history match, yes. Definitely friendly, yes.
And
pulled
the win.
Oh, definitely, yeah. There's, I think this is the first time I've actually flown triple jumps. I didn't fly them. I didn't fly them in their first incarnation when they were easy to play, or should we say, yeah, no, they were easy to play, weren't they, with Deadeye?
Yeah.
So you've got to think a little bit more about this one, which I'm really pleased about. And blocking a Mega Leader was huge. Killing a Mega Leader won me the game. I had a lucky shot that put 3 damage on the Inquisitor, and then after that it was kind of... I never count my blessings until I've actually seen all the ships go off the table, but I was fairly confident without being...
How does it feel defending the noble Wigan Warlord store from the invading Harlequins?
Oh, yeah, well, you see, Lewis has done a reverse double Delapina.
I heard.
But then he got the third one, you see. My adoption papers came through a few weeks ago, and I'm one of the Delabellapinas. So I've he didn't triple Delabellapina. If you
close, though.
Yeah. Close. No, it wasn't close.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much, Alphon.
Very well played.
Thank you. It's been a while since I've won one here.
Yeah, that's George or Sim.
It's normally George or Sim, yes, that's very true. If not, I'm normally on the receiving end of the double Delapina at this tournament, so it was nice to avenge them and get the win. Yeah, it's awesome.
I'm going to go talk to a loser on
Lewis. Lewis, not Lewis. Lewis, not loser.
Pretty close.
L-E-W-I-S, not L-O-S-E-R.
We'll see how he's done today.
Yes.
So,
hello,
Mr. Lewis.
Hello.
You've come down with your friends from the Harlequins.
Well, friends is a strong term.
Associates.
Well, that's a strong term.
People you've vaguely heard of.
Yeah, I know who they are. Yeah,
oh, yeah,
yeah.
And you fought well, 4-0.
Yeah, yeah.
And you were gonna steal our title.
I was trying to. I was trying my best. I'll be honest.
Very good showing.
How
do you feel?
to be honest with you,
just dig him in the ribs.
To be honest with you, I love playing Kev. I absolutely love playing Kev. I love playing all of the Warlords, to be honest with you. And that regard, I mean, you can probably tell from the stream. You know, we're having a laugh. I mean, getting that block off on Omega was massive. That was huge. To be fair, I should have seen that coming, and I think Kev will agree with me. Realistically, I should have seen that coming and maybe curved out of the way. Probably bought another couple of turns with Omega. Could have been a slightly different game. But, you know, Kev played it. He saw it. He played it. I didn't. You know, when you're playing, you know, at a reasonably high level, they're the things that you take advantage of. Kev took advantage of it. You know, he won the game, but it's always a pleasure playing him. It's always a pleasure playing your boys. So I'm happy. I'm happy as Larry. 4-1, doing the double Delapina. Delapinas ain't nothing.
We're coming down?
Definitely, 100%. We'll be back down again. And your boys are going to have to come up to us.
Definitely.
So definitely come up to Harlequins. 2 hours. 2 hours. 2.5 hours in my car.
It's not Scotland.
No, that's true. Yeah.
Yeah, no, not in Scotland.
No.
Despite what people are saying.
Yeah, but you're definitely going to have to come up to the Harlequins. All of you, including you.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah, you're going to have to play. So, no, we had a brilliant time. Thank you for letting us come down.
Oh,
you know.
Good.